So apparently, Leslie Headland has gone to the Bespin Bulletin. Leslie Headland and the Flying Monkeys have gone to the Bespin Bulletin and had Lucasfilm Flying Monkey hit internet hitman Jason Ward announce that The Acolyte is done filming. Say 2 months ago, they were in the middle of filming chapter 4, and literally like 3 weeks later, they were in the middle of filming chapter 5. This is bullshit. Okay. She apparently has Bespin Bulletin and Jason Ward convinced that she's allowed to finish it, even though it's an American production, and there is a Writers Guild strike. And she is a member of the Writers Guild. She is not allowed to cross the picket lines. She is not allowed to be there. Okay, so I call bullshit. They probably ran out of money. And the Flying Monkeys are terrified after the fact of the matter is the narrative for Indiana Jones. Dial of Destiny is that it's going to be crap, and I don't think it is. They need something to make them look like they're actually doing their jobs. And Jason Ward was put in his spot to garner support for Kennedy's ideas of Star Wars and chase fans off. And he failed miserably at that. In fact, apparently, I think I reported on this before, but Sparrow a while back talked about the fact that Ward actually tried to get a job at Lucasfilm and he failed his background check. I have a good idea why he failed it. I can't talk about it. Suffice to say that when Ichibaka and 97 Bravo interviewed several young girls, they basically came forward and said, he tried to groom us, okay? So he's got issues with young women, very young women, underage women, and that might have been one of the things that stopped Lucasfilm, but there's something far more egregious, okay? Let's put it that way. And he would not be a good mix at Lucasfilm because of it. But he sure does have a lot in common with Leslie's former boss, Harvey Weinstein. Okay? He really, really does. It's, when you think about it, this Jason Ward, Flying Monkeys, Leslie Headland romance kind of makes sense, to be honest. Grifters and fraudsters be grifting and frauding, and that's what they all are. So Ward posts that it's done without any acknowledgement of the writer's strike and the fact that Headland is not allowed by the rules to cross picket lines to finish her fucking TV show. Now, you know, you could ask, why haven't we seen anything in the rags? Deadline. THR, Variety. Why haven't we seen more photographs, PR coming out of Lucasfilm for it? The reason is because it's not a real thing, okay? Nothing in our investigations have shown The Acolyte to be anything more than a glorified sizzle reel, okay, to be honest. And reports of it being in the middle of, you know, filming episode 3, that was, I think, in January. And then in April, they were in the middle of filming episode 4. And then 2 weeks later, episode 5. I mean, you know, this is the Flying Monkey's last stand. And it's absolute bullshit. And I think part of the reason why we haven't seen anything in the press about it is that there's another matter happening. And you guys know what that matter is. And it's a little matter of a lawsuit that now it appears that the documents have been taken off of the LA County Courthouse websites. So can't really see where it is now. I thought there's going to be a hearing coming up soon for that. But the lawsuit, Lucasfilm sued for egregious axing a producer, Karen McCarthy, from Star Wars series, The Acolyte. Now, we know why, I think. Kennedy was told, you're not making this show, stop it, by Bob Chapek. And that was at the height of the whoop-de-doo over the Parental Rights and Education Act in Florida. And she went to Headland and saying, get rid of McCarthy because she's not part of the circle of trust. And we're going to put something together with this. I'm going to give you discretionary funds and you film everything, as much as you can from each episode with the actors that we have. And that's what they did. Okay. You know, whatever they were doing in Europe, I mean, we don't know. Hopefully McCarthy's lawyers hired a good private investigator to go and investigate. I would have done it for him. I would have gone to look. But Bob Iger here told Kennedy, you're going to settle this out of court and the money's going to be taken out of your bonus. I mean, now is she even getting a bonus? Okay. With the obvious fact that, sadly, Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny won't break even because of Kennedy's bullshit and the hiring of Phoebe Waller-Bridge and the fact that she tried to Jake Skywalker Indiana Jones. And, you know, look, Bob Iger, who is about as woke as my dog is, was like, no, fucking fix it. So they've done the best they could, okay, and spent likely $500 million on production and then the reshoots. God knows how much they had to reshoot. But there's only so much they could do because they had a deadline, okay? They couldn't push back the deadline, okay? Now Iger's stuck with a movie that, sadly for Harrison Ford, won't be as successful as it should be because of Kennedy. And we also have this Acolyte nonsense.
There is a danger. Should I have your ship standing by?
Evacuate? In our moment of triumph? I think you overestimate their chances.
Down to flight speed, and we're preparing to.
You have failed me for the last time, Admiral. Apology accepted, Captain Nida.
So now we've got Jason Wardistan, and Bespin Bulletin, which is just a stupid website, announcing the Acolyte is finished. And Jason Ward, because he's an arrogant, insufferable, narcissistic, hubristic jackass, thinks that people are going to buy it. There's a writer's strike. And no, she didn't finish it. She had nothing to finish. Okay? And oh, by the way, she's got another show she's doing that she probably can't touch either because of... what? Everybody together. The writer's strike. Okay? Now, this chick right here learned a lot from Harvey Weinstein. Okay? And with Kennedy asking, or basically under the delusion that it's better to ask for forgiveness than permission, they've got themselves in a lawsuit, like I said. So, and I'm going to shove pictures of Weinstein down everybody's throats. And really, Jason Ward and Harvey Weinstein are a match made in heaven. They should date. In fact, they should get married and have kids. Okay, that, in my opinion, is who they are, who Jason is. And this whole grift over the Acolyte is the perfect psyops and, you know, fraud operation that they can use in their madness to, I don't know, create a narrative, get fans to get all pumped up for the Acolyte. It's not happening. I mean, you know, just because you see these pictures like this is taken at Galaxy's Edge, all right? The other picture of Lee Jung-jae, that's literally on the set of Andor, because all of the investigation that I did and looking at to where they've been, quote-unquote, filming, supposedly, it was the same exact studio, the same exact, literally, a soundstage that Andor used. Now we've got Iger, you know, pulling more crap off of Disney Plus to save money. And Jason Ward and Bespin Bulletin, at the behest of the Flying Monkeys, desperate to save whatever jobs they have left, is telling everybody Leslie finished. And we're all going, yeah, but the writer's strike. Okay. So you can believe that there's such a thing as the Acolyte, but it's likely nothing more than a sizzle reel. I'm sure when Iger said he saw it and liked what he saw, why would you say otherwise? Talking to a bunch of people who are likely investing in your company and scaring the hell out of them, okay? Again, there are things you say in public and there are things you say in your private circle. And in the C-suite, the bad stays in the C-suite amongst your trusted allies, not anywhere else, okay? So the fact of the matter is, Iger and Chapek did not okay the Acolyte. The Acolyte is not an official TV show. They've been pretending it is for a long time, and they ran out to go grab their usual suspect, their purveyor of bullshit, Jason Ward, to tell everybody it's finished. All the while, here are the facts. They're getting sued for egregious firing. And now it sounds like that Karen McCarthy's lawyers might even think that the Acolyte isn't real too. Okay. Two, we haven't seen any of that so-called sizzle reel these fuckers showed at Celebration. It was shown to a handful of select people, and what we heard sounds pathetic and ridiculous and stupid, okay? And that's at least two things. Three, Kennedy's delusional if she honestly ever thought there was a clamor and a want from the fandom to see this dumpster fire woke bullshit, okay? There isn't. All right. And with Iger going back to Disney Plus and scraping more garbage out of there, I got to ask, what the hell do they think they're doing? Because eventually Disney is going to say, this show is shelved. We're not doing it officially. Okay. It is going to come out officially. And then they'll all look stupid. All right. You know, Jason will go into a hiding place for 2 weeks and then come back like nothing happened, which is what he always does. Bespin Bulletin will, you know, make up stories. It's stop playing these games. Okay, my advice to the Flying Monkeys is look for new jobs. Do it soon. My advice to Jason Ward, you just get a job. Go touch grass. Go do something. Okay? Get away from Star Wars. And think about how you've spent your life. All right? The time wasting you've done. The pain you and suffering you've caused. People you don't even know. All right? Because of your hatred for them and your unabiding loyalty to a bunch of left-wing scumbags who thought they're the masters of the universe. This is Steph signing out. I'll see you around the galaxy.